I am Xiaoqi Feng. I am a group leader in the Cell and Developmental Biology Department in the Zhang Yinan Center. So my lab is interested in the germ cells. These are the cells that basically bridge the generations and allow life to perpetuate. And we're particularly interested in a feature of the germ cells that they go through these reprogramming, their epigenetic modifications, that basically the modifications on the DNA and chromatin that do not change the genetic code. I enjoyed every minute of having my independent science. I always wanted a lab of my own. I started from being a teenager, I wanted to be a scientist. So being able to do the research I want to do was basically my dream. I have always been fascinated by reproduction because I think that's such an important and key feature of life. And then so I got interested in germ cells from as soon as I was interested in biology, and that just carried on throughout my whole career. And I did a biology undergraduate in China, and then after that I came to the UK to do a master to try to move into developmental biology in plants. And then after that I did a PhD in Oxford University studying molecular genetics in plants. But at the end of my PhD, there was a small period of time I wasn't sure whether or not I should continue to do science, because I really love science, but I also felt like the postdoc is a very stressful period of time, that I felt like there is a limited time, an amount of time that I need to basically succeed within the limited amount of time. And there was that pressure there. And then because of that, I looked for other jobs too. And then when I got offers from other jobs, I was just not ready to take them. And then I realized that I really still have to do science. I know there will be challenges. I know I would be stressed. But then that's why I always say to my students, if you are not sure if you want to continue science, you can also look for other jobs. But by the time you have offers in science and offer outside of science, then you can really compare what you really love. That I just couldn't. I think the other offers were very attractive, but still I just cannot take them. I want to give science another go. And I think that really make me certain that I made the right choice. Yeah. That was followed by a postdoc at the University of California at Berkeley. I did a postdoc for about almost 3 years. And then I got the job at the Zhang Yinan Center, and then I moved back to the UK and started my own group. During my PhD, I was interested in studying the development of the reproductive cells. And then I noticed that during my PhD that there are things that beyond what's encoded in the genetic code that's very important for their functions. So then I studied, basically call them epigenetics, and I studied those in my postdoc, and then in my own lab, I just bring them together, the epigenetics part, regulation part, and also the reproductive development. I think every transition obviously had challenge, and at every transition, I felt like there was a bit of stepping out of the comfort zone. Mm-hmm. And I think being able to do the first couple of them gave me a lot of confidence to say, oh, if I go to a new environment now, what's asked from me is much more than what I used to do, or a different kind of thing, then I know I have dealt with that in the past, and I dealt with it well, and I know that I could continue to do well. I think that really helped. I think my career path compared to other people is quite smooth. I had a short period of postdoc, and I also think at that point I had the wrong idea that the postdoc period has to be short. You must be able to find an independent position within a certain amount of time. I do not think that is true anymore. I think that was just a misunderstanding of the system. I think if you love science and then you do your best, and I think you will succeed, and it really doesn't really matter how many years that you're doing your postdoc. I didn't have to be that stressed now looking back. And that's what I always said to the people in my group and around me. I think just daily, just being very interested, and that just overpowers the doubt. And then by doing it every day, and then you see people's feedback, And then you can tell that they enjoy the supervision and they think it's working well, and then gradually that the confidence just builds up. So I think if people are just starting their own lab, I think it's natural to feel that maybe, you know, oh, I don't know if I could do this, but if you have enough love towards it, I think it's gonna work out, and then it will just slowly, the confidence just slowly builds up. I think it's a very exciting place to start one's group. I felt very fortunate that I have started at the John Innes 7 years ago now. I had a lot of support from all the colleagues. No one ever turned me away when I asked for help. I feel, as a woman, I also feel respected at the John Innes, which is very, very important. And my life choice was also respected, as in I have a child. I had the maternity leave during my tenure track. As a junior group leader, when you entered on the tenure track, you have a mentor. And I had one. I had the absolutely great mentor. She actually, her office is right next to mine, Caroline Dean. I really enjoyed, I learned so much from her, and she helped me so much. She was always, you know, her door is always open for me if I have any questions or anything. I just really enjoyed the whole process, and I think it's a great thing to be able to have that. And then I also think that the fact that Caroline is also a female scientist also helped a lot. And then she has two children. So I feel there are so many things I could talk to her about, not only science but also about life and other things. It's just really amazing. Yeah, she's kind of my science role model, and I really benefited a lot from those interactions.